We can't prevent all hemolytic disease of the fetus and newborn, but we can prevent hemolytic disease of the fetus and newborn caused by anti-D. The first thing we do is a pregnant woman would go to the doctor and they test her blood to see if she's D positive or D negative. We call it Rh positive or Rh negative. If the mother is D positive, she is not a candidate for Rhogam. She's not going to make anti-D because she has the D antigen. If the mother is D negative, we give her Rhogam as long as she doesn't already have the anti-D antibody. We don't care if the baby is going to be Rh positive or negative. We're not going to test the amniotic fluid to see if the baby's Rh positive or Rh negative. We're only concerned with the mother's Rh status before birth. After birth, we are concerned with the Rh status of the baby, and we get the Rh status or the D status of the baby by testing the cord blood that has baby's blood on it. If that tests positive for the D antigen, then we need to do further testing. If it is D negative, we do not need to give the mother Rhogam because she's not going to make an antibody because the baby has no D antigen. But going back to the baby being D positive, we then need to do a screening test for fetal maternal hemorrhage. We need to see how much blood was exchanged between the mother and the baby during birth. If that screening test, which is called the Rosette test, is negative, then one vial, which is 300 micrograms of Rhogam, is fine. And Rhogam is it's a commercial name for Rh immunoglobulin. If the Rosette test is positive, we need to actually quantitate the amount of fetal red blood cells there are. And we do that with a Kleinhauer-Beck test.